Today's topic is 2D viewing and clipping. So to know about the viewing and clipping, we must have the knowledge of the coordinate systems. Now there are three types of coordinate systems. First one is world coordinate systems. Now in case of world coordinate system, it identifies location of objects in the world in the application. So the whole world, all the objects that are lying inside the world, they comes under world coordinate system. Now, next one is model coordinate system. Now, it identifies the shapes of objects and it is attached to the object. Therefore, the model coordinate system moves with the object in the world coordinate system. So, this is called the simulation type of simulation of an object into the model coordinate system. Next one is viewing coordinate system. It is defined by the viewpoint and view site. So, that is where we want to view that object and from where we want to view that system. Now what is 2D viewing and clipping? Now the graphics package allows a user to specify which part of the defined picture is to be displayed and where that part is to be displayed on the display device. So that is there is a graphic package that is used for specifying the picture that we want to display and where we want to display that picture. Now any convenient coordinate system is referred to as the world coordinate system, reference frame, and can be used to define a picture. So all the objects lie in the world coordinate system. For a 2D picture, a view is selected by specifying a sub-area of the total picture area. So, in case of 2D picture, a view can be created by selecting small part of the picture. A user can select a single area for display or several areas could be selected for simultaneous display or for an animation. Now, there are few terms that you must know. Transformation from world to device coordinate involves translation, rotation and scaling operations as well as procedures for deleting those parts of the picture that are outside the limit of a selected display area. Now what is a window? A world coordinate area selected for display is called a window. So suppose we want to display this area, so this will come under window. Now the viewport, it is an area on a display device to which a window is mapped is called viewport. Now these are the two terms that you must know, window and viewport. The window defines what is to be viewed and the viewport defines where is to be displayed. So this is the window, and in this particular window we have defined that we want to see this one, this picture of the area, and viewport is where we want to display that area. Now suppose this is a screen and this is our window, this is the sub area of picture that we want to display. Now we have to identify the place where we want to place this picture, whether this is here, whether here or here. So that is called the viewport. Now the mapping of a part of a world coordinate scene to a device coordinate is referred to as a viewing transformation or window to viewport transformation or the windowing transformation. So these are the different terms that are used for type of viewing transformation. So what we have to do, we have to map the world coordinate scene to a device coordinate. For example, we want to generate an animation. So what we have to do, we will think about the objects and then we will try to map those objects onto the screen. So that is called viewing transformation. Now you can see here. So this is the world coordinates. In world coordinates we have this one, this picture area, and it is lying here. So this is the x-axis of windows. This is the minimum value of x and this is the maximum value of this window x. This is the minimum value of y coordinate and this is the maximum value of y coordinate in world coordinate. Now suppose we want to see only this part of the picture. So this is called a clipping window. So now So this is the clipping window that we have discussed. So what do you want to see? We want to see only this portion. Now we have mapped this window onto the device coordinate, and it will look like this. So this device coordinate will have the minimum value of x here, maximum value of x. This is the minimum value of y, and this is the maximum value of y. So you can say this is the size of the viewport. So this is the way of finding the window. That means what do we want to display and where we want to display. So this is, we want to see this picture, this some area of the picture, and this is where we want to place this picture. So another example is there. Now this is the same world coordinate system, and we want to view this one. So this is the mapping of the world coordinates to the device coordinates. Another one, suppose we have changed the view, we have changed the window. Now we want to see this sub area, so that will be mapped to device coordinates like this. So it depends on the selection what a sub area we want to display. So you can see here, first are the modeling coordinates. Now apply model transformation on the modeling coordinates, then we will get the world coordinates. Now we have to determine the visible parts as we have done in the last example. Then we will get the viewing coordinates. Now we have to apply standard coordinate. We have to map this viewing coordinates to the normalized coordinates, and then clip and we have to clip and determine the pixels, and this sub area of this picture will be shown on the device coordinates. So these are the coordinate systems, viewpoint and view site. As you can see here, this is the world coordinate system, and this is the view site. So now we want to view a cube, and this is the coordinate system, and this is the viewing coordinate system. So this is the view site. Now we want to view this cube, and these are the model coordinate system. So what we have to follow, we have to map the model coordinate systems to the world coordinate system, and then we have to map the world coordinate system to the device coordinate system. So those steps are defined here. So first we will get the modeling coordinates, then we will apply the modeling transformation, and then we will get the world coordinates. After applying the viewing transformation, we will get the viewing coordinates. Now on applying projection transformation on the viewing coordinates, we will get the virtual device coordinates, and then finally we can map the object to the device coordinate. Now 2D viewing transformation pipeline, you can see here the same steps. The modeling coordinates, we will get the modeling coordinate system, and then construct the world coordinate scene from the modeling coordinate transformation. Then these world coordinates are passed, and then we will have these convert this to the viewing coordinates, and then we will transform the viewing coordinates to the normalized coordinate system, and then we will map the normalized coordinate system to the device coordinate system. So this is a window to viewport mapping. This is the coordinates for the clipping window, and suppose we want to map this point of the world coordinate system to the normalized viewport coordinates. So how to map this world coordinate pixel to the normalized viewport coordinate system? So these are the coordinates for the window. This is the mean value of the world coordinate x-axis, maximum value of the x-axis in the world coordinate. This is the minimum value of the y coordinate in the world y point, and this is the maximum value of the y axis at in the window. And you can see here, this is the minimum value of x in the viewport. This is the maximum value of x in the viewport. This is the minimum value of y in the viewport, and this is the maximum value of y in the viewport. So to maintain relative size intuition between clipping window and viewport, what we have to do, we will get this one. that xv minus xv min divided by xv max minus xv min is equal to xw minus xw min divided by xw max minus xw min. So this is for the x axis and this is for the y axis. Now for solving for xv yv, that means we are, this xv yv is viewing x and y coordinates. So xv is equal to sxxw and plus dx, and yv is equal to svyw plus ty. Here scaling factors are this one. This is the scaling factor along x axis and this is the scaling vector factor along y axis. So translation factor will be this one, this is dx. Translation factor along x axis, and this is the translation factor along y axis. So this can also be obtained by composite transformation. So M is the window, normal viewport. Then we will get what we have to do: translation, scaling, and inverse translation. So we will get this matrix. Now, world clipping window can first be mapped to normalized square between minus 1 and plus 1, where clipping algorithm takes place and then transform the scene into viewport given in display coordinates. So this we have in the last slide we have got this matrix sx, sy, tx, ty. Then we have to put these values from this one sx, sy and tx, ty, and then we will get this matrix. Then after solving this matrix we will get this one. Now the clipping operations, the procedure that identifies those portion of the picture that are either inside or outside of specified region of space is referred to as a clipping algorithm or clipping. Now once we have created a window, that means we want to see only that part, sub area of the picture that is visible in this window, then we have to find out which points are inside the viewing coordinate clipping window and which are outside. Suppose this one, this is the outside of the window, this is outside of the window. So we want to see only this part, for example this one. So for that some operations are to be applied so that we can find out which portion of the image is outside the window and which portion of the image is inside the window. Now there is a term, clip window. The region against which an object is to be clipped is called a clip window. So there are different applications of clipping. Extracting parts of a defined scene for viewing, that is the first application. Then to identify visible surfaces in 3D views. We can also apply this clipping for anti-aliasing line segments or object boundaries. We can also use this for creating objects using solid modeling procedures. And we can also display multi-window environment. Now it is also applicable on drawing and painting operations that allows parts of a picture is to be selected for copying, moving, erasing and duplicating. Now there are different approaches for clipping. There are two methods. First method says the clipping algorithm can be applied in one coordinate so that only the content of the window interior are mapped to the device coordinate. So in this particular first case, the clipping algorithm can be applied to the world coordinate. Now second method says the complete world coordinates are mapped first to the device coordinates or normalized device coordinates, and then clipped against the viewport boundaries are applied. So these are different approaches that we can use. Now you can see here. So this is a complete picture, and then we want to see only this sub area. So this is the size of in case of world coordinate system. Now clipping window usually has axis aligned rectangle. So the clipping window can be of any size. It can be a rectangle, it can be a square, it can be a polygon, but it is preferable to have a rectangle. Sometimes rotation is required, and from word to view coordinates, that is inverse translation, possibly followed by rotation. So we can have more complex in 3D, three dimensional coordinate system. Now, what we have to do? First, we have to translate this clipping window to the origin. Then after translating, we will get this. So we have moved this clipping window to the origin. And then we have to normalize the coordinates. So this is a scaling matrix that we can apply the scaling values x axis and y axis. So we have to apply scaling. So if two scale factors are unequal, then the aspect ratio changes distortion. It will result in distortion. Now we have to translate with t. That is the translation factor. X v min, y v min, and then when we will translate, we will have this view here. So you can see here, this is the normalized coordinate 3. So all together, translation, scaling and inverse translation will result in this clipping window. Now assume a window is a rectangular, 4 coordinates are chosen at the experience convenience of the application or user. So this is the window and it is equal to the area of interest within the world. So we can place this window on the object that we are interested in. I will show you an example. Suppose this is the world coordinate system and this is the map. In this this is the clipping window. You want to see only this portion of the map, so that is called the clipping window. Now normalized device coordinate says we will see only this part, not the rest of the part will be hidden. So normalized device coordinates have this 0, 0 and 1, 1, and the screen coordinates will have 0, 0, and these are the coordinates of the screen. Now, this is the pixel in world coordinate and this is a pixel in normalized device coordinates. So this is the way how we can get the viewing coordinates. X-axis, that is V X max V X min divided by W X max minus W X min multiplied by X W minus V W X min plus V X min. So this is the formula for finding the X and Y coordinates in the viewport. Now there are different types of clipping that are available. Today we will discuss the point clipping and the line clipping. Rest of the clippings are area clipping, curve clipping and text clipping. So first we will discuss about the point clipping. Now this is the window, clip window. These are the coordinates of clip window. So and this is the pixel that we want to map to the device coordinate. Now assume that the clip window is a rectangle in standard position. Save a point Cx5, this is the Bx5 point for display if the following inequalities are specified. Now first we have to find out whether the pixel lies into the clip window or not. So how to find out? If this x coordinate of this pixel is greater than equal to xw min and less than equal to xw max, that means this one, and y is greater than equal to xw min and less than yw max, that means this one, then it will lie within this window. That is, that point is inside the window. Now the edges of the clip window are this one. So you can see here, this is the clip window, this is xw min, this is xw max, this is yw min and this is yw max. So and they can be either the world coordinate window boundaries or view boundaries, it depends. If one of the four inequalities is not satisfied, then the point is clipped or not saved for display. Now next one is line clipping. As you can see here, this is before clipping. Now there are number of lines and some of the coordinates of this line lie inside the clipping window and some are outside the clipping window. For example, this P7 is outside the window, P8 is also outside the clipping window, P10, this line P9 is outside the window, P3 and P4 are outside the window, P1, P2 is inside the, completely inside the window, clipping window. But in case of these two lines, this P5, P6 and P7, P8, some part of the clipping window, some part of the line is inside the clipping window and some part is outside the. So after clipping, what we will see? We will see only the portion that lies inside the clipping window. So there are different procedures for finding which part of the clipping window, which part of the line is inside the clipping window and which is outside the clipping window. For example, there are lines are processed using inside outside test by checking the live endpoints. So first case is a line with both endpoints inside the clipping boundaries is saved because that will be visible. Case 2 is a line with both endpoints outside the clipping boundaries is outside the window. That will not be visible. And case 3 says the lines cross one or more clipping boundaries. Therefore, multiple intersection points are to be calculated. Now in case 3, some part of the line will be inside the clipping window and some part of the line will be outside the clipping window. For example, this one. So before clipping we are having this one. And after clipping we will have P1, P2 line inside the, that is the case 1. Case 2 is P9, P10. And case 3 is P7, P8 and P6, P5. So these are the three cases. Now these are the parametric equation of line segment from x0 to y0 to xn to yn. We will get x is equal to x0 plus u, xn minus x0. And similar to case for y where u lies between 0 and 1. So we have to use, it is used to determine the parts contained in clipping window. So the algorithm that is used for line clipping is Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm. So we have divided the line clipping process into two phases. Phase 1 says first we have to identify those lines which intersect the clipping window and so need to be clipped. And phase 2 says we have to perform clipping. So phase 1 is for we have to write the procedure for finding the category of the line, whether that line belongs to case 1, case 2 or case 3. So for that, the step 1 says we have to assign a 4-bit region code to each end point of the line, and then each bit position in the region code is used to indicate one of the four related coordinate positions with respect to the clip window. Now bit 1 represents the left, bit 2 represents the right coordinate, bit 3 the below bottom region, bit 4 the top of the clipping window. Now procedure for finding the category of the line. A value of 1 for any bit position indicates that the point is in the related position, otherwise the bit is set to 0. If the value of x or y lies inside the clipping window, then it is set to 0, otherwise it will be set to 1. If a point is inside the clipping window, then the region code will be 0, 0, 0, 0. So that will be the code. Now, procedure of finding the category of the line. Now we have to calculate bit values in the region code. Now we have to compare the endpoint coordinate values xy to the clip boundaries. Bit 1 is set to 1 if x is less than xw min. That means the x coordinate is less than this minimum value of x. Bit 2 is set to 1 if x is greater than xw max. If x is greater than this one, that means it will lie somewhere here. So it is set to 1. Bit 3 is set to 1 if y is less than yw min. So if the y axis is somewhere less than yw min, then in that case it is outside the clipping window. So that bit is set to 1. And bit 4 is set if y is greater than yw max. So if it is at the top, then the bit is set to 1. Otherwise, the bit will be set to 0. So it will follow the rule for left, right, and bottom and top. LRBD. This is the rule that we follow to set the bit values for the region code. Now the Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm, the complete algorithm. Intersection calculations are expensive. Find first line completely inside or certainly outside clipping window. Apply intersection only to the undecided end. So because applying the algorithm on all the lines, whether they are inside or outside, that will be more expensive. So first we have to find out the lines which are completely inside the clipping window, that are completely outside the clipping window, and the rest of the lines will we can apply the Cohen-Sutherland algorithm. Now we have to perform cheaper tests before proceeding to expensive intersection calculations. Now assign code to every endpoint of the line segment. Now the bottom lines of clipping window divide the plane into two halves. A point can be characterized by a 4-bit code according to its location in half plane. that we have discussed in the last slide. Location bit is set to 0 if the point is in the positive half plane, otherwise it will be set to 1. Now the code assignment involves comparisons or subtractions. Now completely inside or certainly outside tests involve only logic operations of bits. As you can see here, least significant bit represents the left bit, then right bit, bottom bit and the top bit. So this is the clipping window and this is XW min, this is XW max, this is XW, YW min and this is YW max. So any code that is having 00, that means that will lie inside the clipping window. Rest of the, if the code is having any bit equal to 1, then that will lie outside the window. So endpoint codes are 000 for both if and all if line is completely inside. If the endpoint code has 1 in the same bit, line is certainly outside. So lines that cannot be decided are intersected with window border lines. Each test clips of the line and the remaining is tested again for full inclusion or certain exclusion until remaining is either empty or fully contained. Now the endpoints of lines are examined against left, right, bottom and top borders. So it can be, we have to follow the LRBT model for that. Now we will discuss an example. This is the example. As you can see here, we have different categories of lines here. So there are two lines. One line is P1 P2 and another line is P3 and P4. Now we have to find out whether that these lines lie inside the clipping window or not. Now starting with the bottom endpoint of the line from P1 to P2. Now we have to check P1 against left, right and bottom boundaries and find that this point is below the clipping rectangle. So for this we have to find out the we have to generate a vision code for P1 and we will find out that it is not equal to 000. So that means this point is outside the clipping window. Then find the intersection point P1 dash with the bottom boundary and discard the line. Now this is the intersection point P1 dash. Now we have to find out the region code for this and then we have to discard this P1 dash. Now line has been reduced to, now this line has been reduced to P1 dash to P2. Now we have to start from P2. Since P2 is outside the window, check this against boundaries. P2 is calculated, but this is above the window, therefore P2 dash is calculated and line from P2 to P2 dash is, because this P2 dash that are outside the clipping window, so this line P2 to P2 dash has been reduced. Now the remaining line is this one, P2 double dash and P1 dash. So this is inside the clipping window. The intersection point with a clipping boundary can be calculated using slope intercept form of the line. So as you can see here, when we find out the region code for P3 and P4, first we have to find out the code for P4, then we will find out that this is not equal to 000, so it is outside the clipping window. Then the line is reduced to P3 dash to P3. Now it is the intersection of the point, but when we find out the region code, that will not be equal to this one, so this line will be discarded. So this is the example of how we can apply the Cohen-Sutherland clipping algorithm for the finding whether the lines are inside or outside the clipping window.